nut consumption may aid in colon cancer survival. Sounds pretty ho-hum, blasé, easy to pass over. If you knew the difference, and you will in a second, in the survival rate of those who consumed about 2 ounces of nuts weekly for about 6.5 years compared to those that did not, you'd be astounded. It is an incredible, incredible difference. If this was a drug, it'd be considered a breakthrough. In any case, we're just talking a simple dietary inclusion. But however, to proceed as follows. This was an observational study that went 6.5 years that looked at stage 3 colon cancer patients who underwent surgery and chemotherapy. So keep in mind, the authors of the study want to stress there could be other confounding factors. Let's say, for example, if you're not familiar with confounding, confounding could be like, for example, maybe it's those that consume nuts don't consume bacon, and it's the absence of bacon which is increasing survival. However, in any case, it seems to be validated by other studies that were done in the past as well. So there seems to be a solid hypothesis or theory forming in regard to this research. But to proceed as follows, nut consumption may aid in colon cancer survival. Here we go. People with stage 3 colon cancer who regularly eat nuts are at significantly lower risk of cancer recurrence and mortality than those who don't. According to a new large study led by researchers at Yale Cancer Center, the study followed 826 participants in a clinical trial for a median of 6.5 years after they were treated with surgery and chemotherapy. Those who consumed at least 2 1-ounce servings of nuts each week, 2 1-ounce servings of nuts a week, not a lot, but tremendous difference, demonstrated a 42% improvement in disease-free survival and a 57% improvement in overall survival. To proceed, further analysis of this cohort revealed that disease-free survival increased by 46% among the subgroup of nut consumers who ate tree nuts rather than peanuts. Obviously, you know, peanuts really isn't a nut, it's legume, but still, to proceed again, tree nuts include almonds, walnuts, hazelnuts, cashews, and pecans, among others. In contrast, peanuts are actually in the legume family of foods. So not a lot, but yet a tremendous difference. To conclude with the research, to quote the researcher themselves, or the researcher I should say, patients may not be eating nuts due to concerns about the high fat content. For example, a 1 ounce serving of about 24 almonds holds about 200 calories, including 14 grams of fat. Again, quoting the researchers. People ask me if increasing nut consumption will lead to obesity. We're only talking 2 ounces of nuts a week, but again, which leads to worse outcomes, quoting the researcher. But what's really interesting is that in our studies and across the scientific literature in general, regular consumers of nuts tend to be leaner. So per se, counterintuitive to the general population. But however, to the scientific literature, it seems to be something that helps with maintaining a leaner structure per se. Again, just an incredibly, incredibly dramatic result in doing something as simple as just adding a couple of ounces of nuts to a diet on a weekly basis, just 2 ounces. We're not talking daily, we're talking 2 ounces a week. Over a 6.5 year period, literally almost increasing survival, anywhere from about 42% improvement in disease-free survival and 57% improvement in overall survival. And that's if you even include peanuts into the group itself. Again, phenomenal. I hope you find this information of use. And not the most exciting study, but incredibly exciting results. Again, DOI will be listed so you can follow the research on your own, at least to the abstract. Thank you very much for listening. I hope this makes a difference. And as always, thank you. I can go like 7 3 times. See you in 7 days. Catch you then. Bye.